So you can see this is the question which most of the students have marked answer as option A, but I would like to tell you that the answer for this question is option D. So basically, lichenification and lichen planus both are different entities. Please do remember this. Lichenification, lichen planus are not the same. Lichen planus is a papillosquamous disorder. Along with psoriasis, you might have read that if you can remember. But lichenification is basically, as you can see here, over the ankle, you are able to see this kind of hyperpigmented skin lesion, which if you try to palpate, it will be very thick in nature and there are increased skin markings seen. So all these three features put together, we call it as lichenification. And basically, as I have already told you, there will be hyperpigmentation, increased skin thickness and increased skin markings. And this is what is called as lichenification. And basically, if you remember in the eczema topic, the eczema is divided into acute eczema, subacute eczema and chronic eczema. In the acute phase of eczema, that is dermatitis, the skin changes are going to be mainly erythematous lesions will be seen. Along with that, there can be oozing and vesicular lesions which can be seen. That is in acute phase of eczema. Histopath of the acute eczema is going to show you spongiosis. Whereas, as this condition becomes more and more chronic, the patient, because of the constant pruritus, that is itching sensation and the scratching of the skin tries to protect itself by the means of the thickening of the skin. And this thickening mainly happens in the stratum spinosum. Stratum spinosum. And this is what is called as acanthosis. And this is what is called as acanthosis. And in this MCQ, stratum spinosum is not mentioned. So what can you answer? So that entity which has both stratum spinosum and stratum basale, it is called as stratum malpighi. So I hope you do remember that stratum basale, spinosum, granulosum and stratum corneum. These are the layers of the epidermis from below upwards. And yes, stratum basale and spinosum both put together, we call it as stratum malpighi. So since acanthosis occurs and involves stratum spinosum, so we can mark option D, that is stratum malpighi, as our answer here. Okay, so here again it is, chronic eczematous condition, stratum spinosum shows thickening, which is called as acanthosis. I hope this explanation is clear. If at all you have understood this explanation, please do hit that like button below, friends. Okay, and yes, try to remember histopathological lichenification, what is going to happen. Okay, and one student, Charan, has marked it right. So most of the students, marked stratum corneum as the answer. Very, very important to make your basics, correct. Try to remember these basic points. And one more student answered, what is stratum malpighi? Yes, it is stratum basale and stratum spinosum put together, and also Sandy marked it right. Very good. If you have not yet joined the free for all Telegram group for dermatology discussion, the link is there below in the description. You can join with the help of that. And yesterday I have asked one question in alkylating agents video. Regarding anti-metabolite methotrexate, what is the mechanism of action? Yes, very good. It is dihydrofolate reductase inhibitor. And yes, Salim, lichenification does not involve stratum corneum. Please make a correction in your concept. And this is tomorrow's MCQ. Pause this video and try to answer.